Good morning, teachers, seniors, and batchmates. Today I am discussing slide number 165, and the history given to me was swelling on breast. This is photomicrograph of scanner view of my slide, in which we can see fibrous capsule encircling the lesion. This is other side view of the slide, which also shows a fibrous capsule encircling the lesion. This is low power view of my slide, in which the fibrous capsule is more clearly seen encircling the lesion, and the lesion shows few giant cells, one here, here and here, which are not very clear. This is high power view of my slide, in which giant cells are very clearly seen, one is here, one is here, one is here, here, here and here, in the background of mononuclear cells and few foamy histiocytes. This is another high power view of my slide, in which some more giant cells are seen, one here, here, with several foamy histiocytes. Hemosiderin may be seen in these giant cells and foamy histiocytes, which are not clearly visible in this picture. With all above features, diagnosis of this slide is giant cell tumor of tendon sheath or tenosynovial giant cell tumor localized type. Giant cell tumor of tendon sheath or tenosynovial giant cell tumor is a common lesion seen in young and middle-aged people. It is a benign lesion usually seen on the distal extremities like hands, fingers and feet. There are two variants of giant cell tumor of tendon sheath. One is localized type and other is diffuse type. Coming to localized type, it is more common and is benign. It is proliferation of mononuclear cells with foamy histiocytes and multinucleated giant cells which may contain hemosiderin. Grossly, these tumors are small, 1 to 3 cm in diameter, well circumscribed, varying in color from brown to yellowish. This is gross appearance of the tumor, which shows the size to be 1 cm to 1.5 cm. This is cut section of the tumor, in which we can clearly see the fibrous capsule circling the tumor and lobular pattern of the tumor, which are separated by fibrous bands. Coming to microscopy, these tumors are composed of small mononuclear stromal cells with round or reniform nuclei and multinucleated giant cells, foamy histiocytes. These are mononuclear cells with reniform nuclei. These are giant cells here, 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 here and here with foamy histiocytes, some foamy histiocytes. These giant cells and foamy histiocytes may show hemosiderin pigmentation and mitosis may be present, which cannot be appreciated in this view. Coming to immunohistochemistry, these mononuclear cells express positivity to CD45, CD68 and CD163, which is consistent with histiocytic differentiation. Large mononuclear cells express positivity to clustering. Some of the large molecular cells express positivity to desmin, similar to normal synovocytes. Coming to diffuse variant or pigmented villonodular synovitis, unlike localized type, it is diffuse and contains papillary projections like villi. This is one projection here, one and here, which also show pigmentation. The pigmentation is here, here, here. Hence the name pigmented villonodular synovitis. It usually affects the synovium of large joints, grows aggressively around the joints. It is distinguished from localized form by large size, infiltrative growth and anatomical site. That is, it is frequently seen intra-articularly or around a large joint. Coming to molecular cytogenetics, both local and diffuse variants share similar genetic features. Both harbor a chromosomal translocation involving colony-stimulating factor 1 gene located at IP13 and encoding ligand of the tyrosine kinase receptors. High expression of colony-stimulating factor 1 mRNA protein is seen even in tumor cells lacking demonstrable colony-stimulating factor 1 translocations. Differential diagnosis of giant cell tumor of tendon sheath. One is giant cell tumor of soft tissue and other is fibroma of tendon sheath. Giant cell tumor of soft tissues. In this tumor, there is more uniform background of mononuclear cell and sheets of osteoclastic giant cell similar to giant cell tumor of bone are seen. These are sheets of osteoclastic giant cells which resemble osteoclastic giant cell tumor of bone, and this tumor is not associated with any tendon. Other differential is fibroma of tendon sheath. In this Slit-like vascular spaces at the periphery are seen, and this tumor is composed of spindle to stellate fibroblasts and myofibroblasts. And there is lack of giant cells, large histoid cells or foamy histiocytes in this type of tumors. Thank you.